All right, guys, back to work tonight, Tuesday evening. It's April the 6th, 2021. My name is Joseph, and as always, welcome back to your nightly newsletter. Now, if you're tuning in for the first time tonight, it's great to have you with me because my job tonight is to help us fund the best trade setups for tomorrow. That's Wednesday's trading session. I got a great video in store for you guys tonight. Charts are all prepped up in the background, as you can see. We got the S&P, we got the NASDAQ, and of course, that gold on our radar for tomorrow. Got a big day tomorrow, got some big news tomorrow. Got a bunch of ranges, got some strong breakouts. Here, got a lot of great setups we're tracking for tomorrow. But here's the big question on my mind tonight. We'll cover this, of course, in the video. Where do we go from here, right? As we talked about in last night's newsletter, we had that big, strong run-up on Monday. We were expecting these pullbacks, right? Buyers got great pullbacks on the E-mini, on the NASDAQ, and the gold. But now here's the problem, right? They're failing at these highs right now. The S&P fails to go to new highs. NASDAQ fails off the highs. Gold is running higher here, but where do we go from here, right? Where do we go from here? With the buyers unable to push these highs right now, do we sell this market right now? Do we buy more on the pullback? What's the best plan for Wednesday's trading session as we see these buyers getting rejected at these higher highs right now? Not to worry, I'm gonna cover all the details in this video. I'll talk about my favorite long setups. I got a bunch of great spots to buy the shallow pullbacks, the deep pullbacks, and we'll also talk about some reversals because it's easy to see with these ranges, we made some great shots for some trend reversals here tomorrow. Not to worry, by the end of tonight's video, you have a great plan no matter what happens on Wednesday's trading session. Now, of course, before we jump in and get our hands dirty tonight, though, I just want to make sure to remind you, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. You know, we publish this video newsletter with our best trade ideas every evening on this YouTube channel. So make sure you subscribe, hit that bell icon so you always get notified every time I publish something new. And if you have any questions, you can always drop those questions for me in the comment section. And if you'd like the video, as much as I enjoy making it, do me a big favor. If you enjoy this content, hit that like button, hit that thumbs up button, and don't forget to share this video with some trading friends. But thank you so much for tuning in, though. Enough of the intro. Let's get this video going. Wednesday is right around the corner. And as I mentioned earlier, where do we go from here, right? The buyers got everything they wanted today, right? The buyers got that nice dip, and they bought it back up. The dip, and they bought it back up. The dip, and they bought it back up, right? Buyers got pretty much exactly what we talked about in last night's newsletter. But here's the problem, right? They were unable to get through some of these overhead areas of resistance. The buyers have control, but it's obvious they're not too keen on buying high, right? Not too keen on buying high. So do we sell this stuff? Do we buy it? I would love to get long. And there's a couple different spots I'm looking for right now. I'd love to see some deep pullbacks right now on the S&P, deep pullbacks on the NASDAQ. And I've got some options here for both shallow and deep pullbacks on the gold right now. I don't quite think it's time to get short on these markets. I think what's happening is buyers are a little bit weary of buying such lofty prices, and they're searching for lower prices right now to reload the ammo. We're gonna go over all the details here in just a few moments here on the S&P, the NASDAQ, and the gold. Before we jump into these charts though, real quickly here, let's make sure we check the calendar for tomorrow. Tomorrow, of course, is Wednesday, the middle of this second week of the month. Don't forget, the second week of the month is known to be a relatively quiet news week in the markets, right? You can see there's not a lot of major news here for us this week. As we look at the session coming in tomorrow on Wednesday, you'll notice we've got kind of a peppering of news events here. We got the international trade number at 8:30, the petroleum status report at 10:30, and probably the biggest news tomorrow is that FOMC meeting minutes at 2 o'clock Eastern time. Now, of course, I'm not going to worry too much about the first two news reports. The international trade is not a big deal. I'm not going to trade around the petroleum status report at 10:30. Really, the big news tomorrow is that FOMC meeting minutes coming out at 2 o'clock Eastern time. Now, I usually focus on the morning session, right? So most of my trading is done in that 8 o'clock to 11:30, 11:45 block in the morning with all of our clients. So tomorrow, if you are trading tomorrow afternoon, the big news is tomorrow afternoon. There's not a lot of news in the morning session tomorrow that we need to worry about as traders that cover these markets here tonight. But if you are around your charts tomorrow, 215, 220, 230 Eastern time. Everyone wants to see what was going on behind the scene. But these meeting minutes are the notes from the last FOMC announcement. And if you recall, the last FOMC announcement, people were talking about, right, waiting for more data to make any decisions. People will be watching closely those FOMC meeting minutes tomorrow afternoon to see how close they are to making monetary policy adjustments. So I would imagine as this pandemic transitions into the reopening, that FOMC announcement or that FOMC minutes release, again, the notes from the FOMC announcement 2 weeks ago, could really be a very market-moving event. So I don't normally trade the afternoon, but you would definitely wise here to be keeping your eyes on those charts. That 215 to 315, 330 block tomorrow, we may see some pretty good action on the back of that FOMC meeting minutes. Now, of course, there's no major news tomorrow morning, but as always, we do tend to see the best setups in our trade room between 10 o'clock and 11 o'clock. So if you could only be at your desk tomorrow morning for an hour or so, that 10 o'clock to 11 o'clock block, and then again, right, if you got some time after lunch, keep your eyes on those FOMC meeting minutes. Those will probably be, again, a bit of a catalyst for you guys who are trading tomorrow afternoon. So those are going to be the most important times to watch for tomorrow, 10 o'clock to 11 o'clock. Now, again, those have been lately the best setups have happened between 10 o'clock and 11 o'clock. There's no reason why it can't happen earlier or later than that. But if I had to be at my desk for an hour tomorrow, that 10 o'clock to 11 o'clock block is definitely where I would be. And of course, I'll keep an eye on the FOMC meeting minutes tomorrow afternoon and see if we can get a little bump right off of those news reports to finish up the Wednesday's trading session. Now, of course, as always, we get together every morning in our trade room, 8 o'clock Eastern time. We're going to trade these markets together. I'll put a membership link you guys need in the description of the YouTube video if you want to come out and join us tomorrow morning and every morning at the opening bell and trade this stuff together. Back to our charts, though. So now we know the lack of news tomorrow, right, or the major news we have on the schedule. Let's grab a look at the charts here. S&P is ready. NASDAQ is ready. And, of course, gold is ready. Now, of course, in last night's newsletter, we talked about the fact that we had this big, strong bull run up, right, into a trading range. And we talked about, right, finding levels of support below the trading range and using failure patterns, right, to buy going back higher. As I mentioned in the introduction, we pretty much got exactly what we talked about last night on this video newsletter. What we did not get today was the completion of that move higher. Because you'll notice, if I mark up the amount below the range, put it above the range, the buyers really should have tried to push up to that 48.83 half area to complete that pendulum swing. All that really happened, though, was we went up, we pulled back, and the buyers retested the highs. And as you can see now, we really, at this point now, we have rejection of those new higher highs. That's why I said earlier, you know, where do we go from here? The buyers are definitely still in control right now, but this rejection at these highs, it just screams that, yeah, the buyers are here, but they are not interested in buying at higher prices. Whenever we see a market that rejects at the highs like this, we know that what that basically tells us is we need to sweeten the deal, right? We need to give lower prices to attract more buyers. And typically when that happens, you can expect to see one of two scenarios. The first one is we can draw a channel, right? We can mark off those highs, we can mark off that low, and we can start to look at this now in terms of a channel, right? Again, we see rejection at the highs, right? We see rejection at the highs. Buyers don't want to buy high. So what do? Right? They find a level of support underneath and they reload at a lower price. That is one very important component that'll be across the board here on pretty much all of these markets here tonight. The next component is there becomes a big bullseye right on that low. If we go up, right, pull back and then retest the high and again, reject off that high now, if the buyers can't hold the low of that channel I just talked about, there's usually going to be a pretty easy move right back down to take out those lows, where again, we can give the buyers a lower price now to reload and get in again. So in a nutshell, we have a bull market right now, but buyers are screaming at us. They just simply don't want to buy high. That rejection to those new higher highs now tell us we want to find ways to buy at lower prices and really resist the temptation to chase the market as it goes higher. There are really two main components on this chart right now. One is that trading range that I showed you earlier, right? The range, of course, always acts as a magnet. Range bound markets tell me to find support levels to buy below the range, find resistance levels to sell above the range. In this case, it's a bull market, so we're focused on buying those support levels below the trading range. That range is one of the key components. The second, and really what might be the most important component now, is that new channel. We mark up those highs, bring it down to that low, and we can start to kind of see here now how that rotation may come into play here for tomorrow. So knowing those are the two main components, knowing the buyers have control of this market, what's the best way now for us to buy this thing as it tries to continue going higher? Well, the first thing to worry about is the middle of this trading range. You know, one way to look at this is if I draw my channel like this, and if I want to be buying off this low, right, I'm now going right into the middle of that range. And, you know, I talk about this quite a bit on in our video classes here at School of Trade. We want to do our best to avoid trading inside the middle. So unfortunately, we're not going to get my favorite chance here. I'll talk about my favorite setup for tomorrow here in a second. But really what we want to do is you want to anticipate now those bears are trying to run back down to those lows. So as I come off the low of this channel right now, I'm going to give the benefit of the doubt to the bears, let them try once, let them try twice, and then there's a couple different ways I can get into this trade. I can look for a trap below that low, which would always be one of my favorites, or I can look to buy into stop losses as the market runs higher. So ultimately, I want to give, again, the bears the benefit of the doubt on this, mostly because I'm inside of that trading range. And again, whenever we see the market in a bull market fail off that high, you know there's a big bullseye back down at that major low. So in the meantime, if the buyers do want to rotate off the low of this channel, which is one of the most important components on this market for tomorrow, that failure pattern will be a really, really easy way to do it. And again, there's two ways to look at it. One would be the trap low, right? Bears try once, bears try twice, and a trap low. The other, of course, that trap low would be the most ideal there. The other one is simply buying into stop losses, right? As the bears try once, they try twice. Their stops are sitting right above those highs. And of course, we can buy into those stop losses for what? A target back up to retest those highs. And I would definitely try to leave at least a piece of that position open to reach that pendulum swing target up overhead. So that, of course, is kind of the shallow pullback, if you will, using that channel. Now, we may also see the market nosedive here, right? As you can see, I've got this channel I've drawn in off those lows up around that high. We may see these bears come in and run this thing going lower, which is very much expected because, again, when you have that rejection off the high, it's basically telling the buyers are basically screaming at us, we don't want to buy these higher prices, give us something lower. And so generally it's just below the low of that deepest part of the pullback. Now, if I remove these channels here just for a second, just to kind of clear it up a little bit here, if we do get that run now, right? If we do get this market now running down to take out those lows, we have to begin to worry about momentum starting to shift here for the sellers. We call this rotation off the high. We did not have this problem in last night's newsletter. In last night's newsletter, we were just simply a bull market into a trading range. So once we saw a pullback, we could get pretty aggressive and buy going back up in. That is not the case this time around. This time around, we are not trading inside the range. We are simply coming off the top of that range. And of course, momentum will begin to build here for the bears. Now, why is it important for us to be a buyer down here? Well, because because once we come down, what'll happen is there'll be some trend lines down here. There'll be a lot of bearish momentum. And the easiest way to kind of keep yourself out of trouble in these situations while looking to get long is to look for that same kind of failure pattern as I mentioned earlier. Now, again, because the bears will have so much more momentum, in this case, I want to give them a chance to sell twice. Let them try once, let them try twice. And again, right, there's a couple different ways I can enter this trade. I can look for the trap below that low, and I can also, of course, buy into stop losses. These are two really, really reliable ways to get long, right? So again, I don't want to force it, but I do want to buy off these lows. And to do that, give the bears the benefit of the doubt. Let them try once, let them try twice. And of course, once we get those bears in, right, we know exactly where their stops are. Their stops are hanging out right above those highs. If I get the trap, great. If I don't, I can always buy it right as it's rolling higher. Now, keep in mind, these types of failure patterns, they oftentimes will really shoot higher here. And momentum will really start to cruise back in the opposite direction. In this situation, you can actually go out, draw a new trend line off that high, find a new channel now, and that first pullback is very, very reliable. So it really sets you up for, again, trap low, buying there into stops, or buying that first pullback off of that low. It would be a failure pattern into a pullback pattern combination. And guys, we see a lot of these kind of combination setups, right? Failure into pullback combinations. I go over a lot more detail of these combination setups in our free trading course. So make sure you grab that link that pops up there. If you want to see more of the actual entry triggers that we use in our trade room, specifically those failure into pullback combinations, I'll put a little pop up there for you in the upper right hand corner for our free trading course here at School of Trade. That way, the next time I say failure into pullback combination, you'll know exactly what it really looks like on a real chart, right? I'm just simply marking the things up right now, right? But you'll know after that free course, you'll know what I'm talking about by failure into pullback combination. Now, you're probably wondering, well, if we go lower like this, at what point do we start trying to sell this market, right? So let's say, for example, we do take out these lows, right? Now, what point now do I start to get bearish? At what point do I sell this? We can sell this as soon as these bears take out that low and hold a pullback and go. We call these 1-2-3 breakouts, or in this case, 1-2-3 reversals. Remember, that trading range in the middle is a magnet. So what goes down will likely come right back up. Again, I do have to respect the momentum by giving the bears two tries to get long. But at the same time, though, if these bears can take out that low, if they can hold that pullback to the moving average and show me some strength on that 1-2-3 breakout, I now know this trading range has lost its grip. The sellers have now taken control, and I want to get short now. How do we get short? I'm going to sell the first pullback. Mark off that low, mark off that high. That creates a new bear channel, and I can look for that short off the top of that channel. Now, of course, we're not just simply selling the top of that channel. I like to look for things like bull traps, buyer failures into pullback combinations, and of course, strength moves on the way down. I'm not going to go into all the details of those specific entry techniques, but again, I do cover all those in more detail in that free course, in that free trading course linked up in the upper right-hand corner. Where would these bears be trying to get to? Well, remember, there's that big range down there at 40.25 that we talked about in last night's newsletter. So if the bears do sink their teeth into this thing, that 40.30, 40.25 area is going to be a really nice spot for a target for the bears tomorrow. Now, how do we buy this thing if it goes higher? Okay, so we talked about now how to trade this as it goes up, right? We talked about how we look for that one try, that two try, right, and up from there right now. All right, but what if this market starts to really run? What do we look for as we're going higher? There are two specific patterns I'm looking for if we get a nice rally going higher. The first one is going to what I call a two-try breakout. That is a strong run higher. If I can see a very strong run higher, and in fact, we saw one right here, we see a strong run up, a shallow pullback, a higher high in price, and a trap below that low. That is a great example of exactly what I'm looking for over here now. If we see a very strong run higher here, if we see a shallow pullback, right? Shallow pullback creates urgency in the market. Higher high in price confirms the move. Then I can look for that two-try trap. Same idea, right, as we saw earlier around 10 o'clock, 10:30 here this morning. That's one setup as we go higher. Another one would be a strong move higher, a pullback to the moving average, and a jump off the moving average. Now you'll notice we did not get that today, right? It's one of the biggest reasons why we're talking about where do we go from here, right? The buyers were unable to hold that pullback. However, if these buyers can get that one, two, three go, now we have enough momentum. Now that range below us acting as a magnet has lost its grip. And now these buyers, for whatever reason, have got their mojo back, and now they're trying to go for more, right? Possibly up to that 4,100 big round number. What do we do in that situation? Do we buy the high? Of course not. We buy the first pullback. Wait for that high to get made, mark that channel from the high down to that low. And again, it's the first pullback, right? The first test is always the best test of those new hidden channels. And again, we're not just blindly buying it, right? We're looking for things like bear traps, looking for seller failures, looking for pullback combinations, and of course, strength moves as we go higher. I cover all of these specific entry triggers in that free trading course that I mentioned earlier. Now, can I sell this high? Can I sell this high right now? If we go up and take out that high, can I sell this thing? I mean, after all, doesn't this range act like a magnet, right? Aren't ranges like magnets? They definitely are. And you can sell off that high. Here's the minimum though. We have to go out and take out that high. Once we take out that high, who has control? The buyers have control. So we have to give them the benefit of the doubt. Let them try once, pull it back. Let them try twice, and you want that trap high for that crown reversal pattern to sell short back off that high. You can see it very similar back here, right? We go up, we pull back, buyers try once, they go lower, buyers try twice, right? And it ends up rolling back down into that trading range. That same basic idea, right, is exactly what we're looking for here again, here tomorrow. So again, buyers have good control, right? But will they, again, will we see this market 1-2 back up and finish off this channel rotation? Or will we get that big run, take out those lows, and then 1-2 and right back up? This is the one that I want to get. This is the one I always look for. Anytime we see rejection off the highs like that, there's a big bullseye right on that low. But once they get to that low, their job's not over yet, right? They have to hold that pullback and get that new channel, and then we can start to get short right off that new channel. If they don't, professionals like us are waiting one, waiting two, all those stops are right there, and we can use those stops as gasoline, right, to fuel this sucker right back up into that trading range. So now we know the plan though, right? We know how to trade it if it goes up, if it goes down. Keep in mind too, if we do end up going sideways and getting stuck inside the range, right, just stay out of trouble inside that trading range. And I'm sure there are going to be some other things that happen tomorrow, so make sure you come out and see us tomorrow morning in the trade room. We'll make sure we cover any missing pieces from tonight's video. And again, grab that free trading course to learn more about our entry triggers. Now, over to the NASDAQ here. NASDAQ is very similar, right? You can see here to the S&P. Long story short, in last night's newsletter, we had that strong move up, right, into that trading range. We knew that range would act as a magnet. We also knew the bulls had all the control. So we found our levels of support below the range, and we wanted to buy with failures underneath that trading range. As you can see here, what happened was, right, the buyers got their pullback. They went back up to retest the high. And again, there is rejection off of that high, right? Buyers definitely have the edge. They definitely have control, but there's clearly a problem. Buyers, for whatever reason, it could be that measured move we talked about last night, that triple measured move, did a pretty good job at holding there. There's also, of course, this pendulum swing below, pendulum swing above. You can see the amount below the range, amount above the range creates that level of resistance. So you can easily see the measured move is there, the pendulum swing is there. There was also a resistance trend line up there as well. So the buyers, again, right, buyers fail to push higher. We get that strong run up, that deep pullback. They try to go, but they get rejected. As you can see here now, bears, of course, or should I say bulls take profit. We get that strong pullback off the high. And anytime we see a strong move like that, you would expect them to retest that low. So all is pretty much, you know, it all makes sense to me here. Buyers are looking for a way to buy at a lower price. Now, let me clean this thing up here real quickly for us here. We have that rotation off the high. I've got my leg one, my leg two, which is giving me some levels of support down here for an ABCD or a measured move. So at this point now, we know there is a big bullseye right at that low, right at 524 and change. Again, we know there's a big bullseye there because after seeing these buyers struggle to push the highs, they're going to need to sweeten the deal here and find some longs underneath those lows, right? Basically at a cheaper price to attract those buyers in. So that's where I'd like to get my favorite entry here for tomorrow. At the same time though, I've got my channel, right? Just like on the S&P, mark up that channel high, bring it down to that channel low, and you can see what happened here, right? They got down to those lows. The bears tried once, the bears tried twice, right? And they're getting the job done here. So at this point now, I'm thinking very similar here to what we talked about on the S&P, right? As we go higher, if I can get these bears trying once, trying twice here, I can use those stop losses fuel to buy back up and complete that rotation back up to the high of that channel. The other scenario would be we finish off this move, we take out those lows, maybe we go all the way down to that trend line. Again, the pendulum swing now, you'll notice I mark up the amount above the highs, below the lows. That gives me now some support. There's a lot of support levels you can see down here below this trading range. So it really all depends on what we get here in the short term. If we go higher here, right? If the market does try to go higher here right now, again, much like on the S&P, I want to be aware of the situation, right? I'm going to be buying relatively high up here, right? I mean, let's face it. If I try to buy this next pullback, I'm buying relatively close to that high of day from earlier today. It doesn't mean the buyers can't keep going with this, but it'll be a good idea for me to let this to give the bears a little bit of a chance here to kind of wrap that rope around their neck, dig their own grave here. Let those bears try once, let them try twice, and again, two ways I can enter off of this trade. Remember, keep in mind, it's this channel, right? It's this channel is what we're trying to do here, right? So we take out those lows, we kind of scratch the itch for the bears there, take out those lows. Now as we go up, right, bears try once, bears try twice. Can I get lucky and get a trap low on this, right? That'd be one way to do it. Again, same idea here on the S&P, right? So we're trying to buy the low of this channel, let those bears try twice at higher prices. Do I get that trap low? Nice strong green candle, right, coming off of that low? Or do we not get that trap low and can buy right into those stop losses, right? Both of those will work on that way back up to retest the high of that channel, right? Again, these are failure setups. And keep in mind too, remember, don't forget, we oftentimes will see this thing run up. You'll get that new channel coming off that high and you can get that combination entry, right? That failure into pullback combination. So again, bears trying twice, grab the trap, grab the stop run, and then grab the pullback on the way up to the high of that trading channel. Three relatively easy setups, or three pretty consistent entry points there on the way back higher. We talked about that already on the S&P. Same thing also, right? If we go lower here, what's going to happen? We're at a great location down here, right? That's a great spot to want to be a buyer. But here's the problem. It's very bearish now, right? Well, again, we have this rotation from above the highs. We didn't have that problem in yesterday's chart, right? Yesterday, the market was just straight up and going sideways. So I could get pretty aggressive using a failure pattern, right? Buying below the low of that channel. This time though, not the same, right? This time we go up and now we rotate all the way back down. Those bears have a lot, they've got a lot more juice behind this move now. So if we do see this thing roll over here and go lower, right? Now what do? We got to give the bears the benefit of the doubt, right? Let them try twice. Let them try once. Let them try twice, right? Remember, at that point now all their stop losses are sitting right above those highs. The range overhead acts like a magnet, right? The range overhead acts like a magnet. So once those bears try a few times, and again, I like to give them two tries because of all that momentum coming off the highs. Once we've got those bears trying twice, there's a couple different ways you can enter this stuff, right? I can draw a trend line off that low. I can buy off that trend line. I can grab the long off of that trap, right? And I can also, of course, grab the long into stop losses as we go higher. There's a lot of different ways you can use those, what I call failure setups, right? Failure setups at that low. And then again, don't forget, right? Don't forget, oftentimes this thing will rip going higher. If you get that much momentum now running higher, don't even hesitate. Grab that high, grab that low, get in on that first pullback with your bear trap entries, your seller failure entries into pullback combinations. Any of my favorite entry triggers will work off the low of that channel if we can get that nice rotation, right? That nice rebound going higher. Because at that point now, there's a big bullseye right back at those highs and everyone's gonna wanna jump in on this. And again, I'm not gonna go over all the specific entry techniques I'll use on this, but if you wanna get a much deeper dive into all the entry techniques, in fact, I'll send you a lot of examples of how we apply these entry patterns on our favorite futures markets, definitely grab that free course pop up there in the upper right-hand corner, right? That'll give you a lot more information so you'll be ready for those entries if you're trading alone, or you'll be ready to trade with us in the trade room at 8 o'clock every morning. So now we get a pretty good plan how to buy it. So if the market goes lower though, at what point do I try to sell this thing, right? As it goes lower here, we take out these lows here. When do I sell it? I sell it once those bears can hold that pullback and jump, right? Once I can get that 1, 2, 3 move, remember, it's not enough to see a big breakout, right? We see lots of big, strong breakouts that can't hold and go, right? They can't hold and they fail back down in. We see lots of big, big, strong breakouts, but they can't hold, right? And they go right back up into the range, right? Look back here. Okay, that's exactly the situation we're trying to avoid, trying to sell those bear breakouts. So if the market does make a run lower, does take out these lows here, that's a great first step. But now the bears though, they've got to prove to us they actually want this thing. We have to remember, we kind of break free of that magnetic pull of that trading range. So in this situation, I'm going to wait for those bears to hold the pullback and go. All right, once they do hold that pullback, 1, 2, 3, now I know we've broken free of the magnetic field of that trading range, and when the bears have control, I'm not going to sell it down here. I'm now going to wait for the first pullback. I'm going to mark that low. I'm going to mark that high, and looking for the first test, right? That's always the best test, as we always say. 1, 2, 3 breakout, or in this case, 1, 2, 3 reversal too, right? It's a bull market, it's a reversal pattern as well, into a hidden channel pullback. Off that high, I'm looking for bull traps, right? I'm looking for buyer failures into pullback combinations, and of course, into strength moves going lower. Check out the free trading course linked up in the upper right-hand corner for more of the specifics on those entry techniques. Now, where do we think the bears wanna go, right? The bears, of course, they want to go back down to, just like the S&P, they want to go back down to get that range. And not just any range, we also have a weekend gap from last Friday, right? Last Friday's Good Friday holiday session. So there is a big magnet down there, 13,350, that definitely could come into play here tomorrow if these buyers can fail and the bears can take control. So we got a pretty good plan of attack, right? As the market goes lower, one thing you would want to be careful of is if we do end up going sideways and getting stuck inside this trading range, just keep on following the plan, right? The plan doesn't really change if we end up going sideways here inside the range. And don't forget, tomorrow morning, I'll be right there with you in the trade room to make sure you don't get in trouble inside of that trading range. Now, what if the market runs higher, right? What if we get that one try for the bears, two try for the bears, and we do get that rip higher here? What would be some options as we go? Well, one easy to see option would be a move up, a pull back, and a jump, right? That would definitely be a 1, 2, 3 break higher here. If I can see enough momentum coming off the moving average with the buyers in control and some easy targets waiting up overhead, I can mark up that high, I can mark up that low, and I can grab, again, a bear trap, right? A seller failure pattern, a pullback combination, right? Or a strength move coming off of that low. We call these 1, 2, 3 breakouts into hidden channel pullbacks. And again, we're not just simply buying that low. We're looking for one of our favorite entry triggers, which you'll learn more about in our free video class. So we've got that covered as we go higher. If things really get crazy, right? If they really start to run going higher here. Remember, the NASDAQ has yet to retest its all-time highs yet, right? The S&P is up in, you know, spaceship territory right now, right? All-time highs right now. The NASDAQ has yet to get there. So the NASDAQ definitely has some room to go. But again, we've got this trading range, right? So we've got to get that, let's say 1, 2, 3, right? Nice big strong run higher here. Get that strong run higher. Get that shallow pullback, that higher high in price. Whenever we see a strong run higher, right, followed by a shallow pullback and a higher high in price, especially if these bears, right? Remember, the bears should be running back down to those lows right now. If this thing turns around and rips higher here, what does that say about the bears? The bears are beat, and that means buyers will be looking for whatever chance they can get in to buy as low as possible. Now, as always, there's extra bonus points if you can combine that entry pattern with the low of a new channel, right? So grab that trend line off the high, grab that trend line off the low, and see if you can't combine that trap low along with the low of that new hidden channel. All right, so some pretty good spots there to buy if we can get this momentum starting to push higher. And again, I can't emphasize enough, if the bears fail, right, if they fail to go back and take these lows out, that is really a major failure for the sellers and a big, big clue here for the bulls going in tomorrow. Now, speaking of bulls tomorrow, could I sell these highs? Where would be the best place to get short off the highs? We know how to trade the 1, 2, 3 breakdown. We know that. The next thing would be, can we take out these highs and get a crown reversal, right? As we go higher here, we take out the highs, the buyers come back, they try to buy it once, they pull back, they try to buy it twice. That is definitely something always on my radar anytime I have a range underneath us. Right? So if we don't see, now remember, this is a very different pattern setup. Bulls try once, bulls try twice, and a trap high, right? That is a crown reversal pattern. It's a very different setup than if you were to go higher here, shallow pullback, higher high, right? That is, of course, that two try trap. Or if you were to go up, hold the pullback and go, right? That's a 1, 2, 3 breakout pattern from there. But if we can go up, right, take out those highs, get those buyers to try once, lower high, pull back to a lower low, buyers try twice, little trap low there, right? Great, great spot there to get short. I also like to draw trend lines off of those lows, up around that high, and look to short off the top of that channel. So really, I love that setup, especially when we have that range acting as a magnet down underneath us. So I'll be keeping an eye out for that as well. And again, don't forget, I know we're covering a lot in this video right now, but I'm going to make sure we know exactly where these entry setups are tomorrow morning in our trade room. So make sure you come out and join us. In fact, if you're still watching this video right now, that tells me you are serious about your trading career. And I'll tell you, there's no better shortcut that I can give you than showing you how to do this while we're trading together every morning in our trade room. What I'll do is I'll put a link in the description down here if you want to come out and join us 8 o'clock Eastern time, Monday through Friday. We trade this stuff together because, you know, as you can probably imagine, I can't cover every single possible situation for tomorrow. I'll do my best, obviously, tonight to give you guys my plan of attack and where I think the best setups will be, the entries and exits. But the real key will be to come out and join me tomorrow morning and trade it right there with me, because that's just the easiest shortcut to this correctly. So over to our gold right now. And again, I'll put all the links you guys need to get registered for tomorrow's trade room. I'll put all those in the description of the YouTube video, or I'll put them in the big button for you guys below this video tonight on the trading blog. Let's wrap things up now with the gold. What do we have here on the gold? Well, as you recall on the gold from last night's newsletter, we had a very similar situation, right? Last night we had this bull market into a trading range, and we talked about that one option was to buy the pullback, right, with a failure pattern, which is what happened on the E-minis today. We also talked about the fact that we had what looked like a spike in channel, right? And if you recall last night, my exact words were, if we do get this rise higher, just simply find that channel and use one of those nested failures to buy off the low. So if you follow kind of the strategy we talked about in last night's newsletter, hopefully you're ready to go, right, buying that pullback off the low of that channel, right? We had that nice little spike in channel there that we talked about last night. So that's pretty much what happened today, right? The buyers got that strong jump up. We, of course, update our, right, in this case, it was that high to that high, find that low right there, right? And that was the low of that channel. Again, we talked about this in good detail last night. So the buyers get what they want, right? They got their long off the low of that new channel, and now the market sprints higher here, as you can see. But you'll notice it looks like these buyers are a little bit weary because they started going sideways here, you know, not too long into the morning session this morning, right? The buyers started going sideways about 10 o'clock Eastern time. So when I look at this market right now, it's just straight up bull market into a trading range. And we talked a lot about this last night. I'm going to measure the size of this move higher. That'll give me a nice, easy, measured move target here for tomorrow, right? And my job right now is I want to find support levels below this trading range, right? The trading range acts like a magnet. And as you may recall from last night's newsletter, there are two basic ways to trade a bull market into a trading range. One is to get long at support levels using failure patterns below the range, which again is what happened in the S&P and the NASDAQ today. The second scenario is we trade breakouts, right? And there are two types of breakout patterns. There are 1, 2, 3 breakout patterns. We mark up the high, mark up the low, and we buy the first pullback off the low of that channel. There's also, of course, that 2-try breakout, that strong move up, that shallow pullback, that higher high, and that trap below that low. So those are kind of the three main components we're watching for here, right? Can we get that move lower, that failure pattern, or do we see the market run higher here, right, with one of those two breakout patterns? That's kind of the general idea here, right, for the gold going forward. Now, we may not sit inside this range very long. So if we do end up pulling back here, think of this in two types of pullbacks. My job right now is to find support levels underneath this trading range. What I've done is I've found a channel, right? There's one way to look at it. So there is a channel, and I can definitely buy the low of that channel. Now, to do that, I'm going to have to be careful because I'm not going to want to trade right inside that channel. It would also be a relatively shallow pullback. So in these situations, it's best to let the bears try once, try twice, and just simply use those stop losses fuel for what could potentially be a failure into a pullback combination going higher. Again, give the bears 2 tries here to sell short. You can see an example back here, right? And the reason why you do that is because it's not a very deep pullback, right? We see the market go up, it pulls back, bears try once, bears try twice. Their stop losses are the fuel, right, that send this market running higher. I've got a great looking channel here. The problem is that channel is just a little bit too close to that trading range. It's not a very deep pullback. So as we do take out the channel low, bears try once, bears try twice, all their stops now are easy fuel for the fire. We buy into stop losses. And again, remember, a lot of times it'll come right over here now, and you can buy that first pullback off the moving average, right? It's a failure into pullback combination. We see a lot of those combination setups. Now, I've also got this trend line down here. That trend line is also a really nice spot for it, because if I can get that pullback down to that trend line, now I'm not so concerned about location. Now I can go out, get those bears to chase this thing going lower. Once those bears get short off the moving average, now their stop losses are right above the high. That range acts as a magnet. And just like we talked about on the NASDAQ and the S&P, I can buy right into those stop losses for an easy run now back up to retest those highs, right? It's a failure pattern underneath, right? Underneath that range. Now, we may also see a deeper pullback, right? If it pulls back any deeper, we have to start worrying about them holding the underbelly, right, of that trend line, right? That will happen a lot in these kind of trend line with a range underneath us scenarios. So if we do end up getting underneath that support trend line, my concern is twofold. My concern is momentum. Momentum is a very, you know, very strong pullback here. And I'm also thinking the bears are going to put up a fight to sell off that trend line. This is actually a really good setup. The problem is you want to wait patiently for it, right? You want to wait for the bears trying once. Let them try twice here. Once we've got those bears committed, now this is one of those scenarios where, because you have such a deep pullback now, that nice swing going higher here, right? As this market runs higher, this is where you can look for one of those combination setups, right? That nice deep pullback. So again, it's a bear failure. We're buying off a trend line, we're buying the stop losses, we're buying that pullback off the low of that hidden channel on the way back up to retest those highs. That would be a great, great setup for tomorrow, again, to get that really deep, deep pullback. And obviously, right, if we do get that deep pullback, and if those bears can hold the pullback now and run, now that creates that 1-2-3 reversal pattern, and I can mark that low, I can mark that high. And honestly, I don't care where we are at that point. If we have enough momentum here with a 1-2-3 reversal pattern, I will be looking for whatever entry trigger I can use to short that high. Maybe a bull trap, maybe a buyer failure, a seller pullback combination, a strength move, right, coming off of that high. Again, I'm not going to go into all those small details here tonight, but you can learn more about the small entry triggers we use in that free trading course linked up in the upper right hand corner. And then again, that range below us will act as a magnet, right? So make sure you stay out of the middle of that range here once we get back down into it. What if we keep going higher here? If the market keeps on grinding higher here, what do? You know, not a lot changes, to be honest with you. If we go higher here, we keep grinding higher, I'm going to keep that channel, I'm going to keep that trend line, and not a lot changes, all right? So as we go lower, shallow pullback, 1-2, failure. As we go, right, as we go deeper, failure into pullback combination. If we really collapse, right, bears try once, bears try twice, and let her rip into that failure into pullback combination here, right, getting in off of those deep lows, right? So it's very similar here, right, if we do keep grinding higher here. You know, and as always, you know, if it goes sideways here, stay out of the middle. If we end up chopping around sideways and we get a shallow pullback here, remember, bears try once, bears try twice, then up from there, right? So shallow pullbacks, look for those nesteds. If we can get a much deeper pullback at that point now, that will free up the space we need into those failure back up into that trading range. All right, guys, I know I'm running late here in the video right now, so I don't want to cover too much more here tonight. We will cover more of these details in tomorrow's trade room. We've got some big overhead levels of resistance up here at that 1756. So as we go higher, be careful as you're buying high. A lot of great levels here on the gold, right, going higher here. But again, as we go higher here, wait for that pullback, right? Buy those pullbacks here right now at these areas of support. And who knows, maybe the bears can take control of this market and go back into that range waiting down below us. But that's it for now, guys. That covers all of our favorite markets, my favorite setups for tomorrow. I hope I will see you there with us at 8 o'clock Eastern time. Don't forget, I'll put all of the membership links you guys need. I'll put those in the description of the YouTube video. If you're on the blog right now at Sideways Markets, click that button for me right below me tonight on the trading blog to get registered, and I'll plan on seeing you tomorrow morning at the opening bell. If not, don't forget, you can always call me in the office. I'm always here. I can always help walk you through the entire process. We've got live chat on the left. I got live chat on the right. And as always, you can just simply type your questions in to the comment section if you have any here. I hope by now you subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hit that like button if you guys enjoy the content tonight. And make sure you come back and see us next time. As always, my name is Joseph. Be well out there. Be nice to each other, will you? And be here tomorrow. Adios, amigos. Bye-bye for now.